ladies and gentlemen. My name is Scott Perry Johnson, author of The Abandoned Poets. And today, we're here to talk about the tragedies and starvations and deaths that happen in Ethiopia. It's not fun. I'm lucky enough to be an Australian, as is my good friend here. Would you like to say hi to Ethiopia?
Hi.
Bruce would like to say hi to Ethiopia. What would you like to say?
I hope everyone is doing okay.
Me too. Well, we're going to do some special things here today. Tonight. Depends where you live, really. And we're going to promote some awareness. Because I think it's about time. Instead of death like this. And violence. And spread from starvation. So we're going to be looking up some very special videos. After this. I don't like preachy people. I don't like people who preach. I don't like people who force preach. No. But we will make our point. And we will make it happen. I care very deeply about people. The point is, people just don't care about themselves. I know I don't. But I wish I did. But this isn't about me. It's about you.
This year, the spring and summer rains failed, leaving parched earth and scrawny cattle. Bertakan Ali's tears are for the son she buried a few days ago. His name was Abdu Muhammad. He was 5. His grave crowned with freshly picked vines. Malnutrition now stalks northern Ethiopia.
When he died, I felt I had lost everything. My family buried his body. Everyone is in hardship. We all have so little to eat because there was no harvest this season. Everyone is suffering.
The UN says in one area, 2 babies have been dying every day. Bertakan, one of many mothers, left inconsolable. At this well, things are getting desperate. People travel here from miles around to give their livestock a drink. But the water table has fallen to almost nothing. 30, maybe 40 meters down, it's full of silt and mud. The well almost dry. Help is arriving, too late for some, and in too small a quantity for the scale of the emergency. At this food distribution center, 2,000 people wait for rations that will last them a month. In all, more than 8 million people across an area roughly the size of the UK now need food aid. The drought has reduced yields from this year's harvest by as much as 90%. The village of Kayugaria, population 5,000, sits in the heart of the drought zone. This substantial watering hole was a lifeline for livestock in the village. Now it is bone dry. In fact, the moisture content of the soil in this area is the lowest it's ever been. Many here remember the 1984 famine that spawned the global humanitarian response and the Band-Aid single. Abara Weldu, now in his late 60s, has lived here all his life.
Although this drought has just started, it's going to get worse. It's already really severe. Some people have died of hunger. Others are sick in their beds. Right now, it's just like 1984.
The government is in much better shape than 30 years ago to cope. Officials were in the village today, but more international help is needed.
We went from 4.5 to 8.5 million people needing food aid in just the last 2 months. We know it's going to get worse soon. We know that the needs next year are going to be far higher and far more entrenched. And despite our massive best efforts, including remarkable efforts by the government, this is not enough.
By early next year, local food reserves will run out, leaving as many as 15 million people relying on aid, more than need help in Syria. Bertakan has already paid a heavy price for the cruelty of Mother Nature. Who'll be next? Clive Myrie, BBC News, in northern Ethiopia.
Well, that was powerful stuff, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to thank my good friend Bruce, my friend, my partner, and my guardian. Yes, I would very much like to thank this man. And there's nothing. This is a wonderful person. And I truly believe. I don't care what the fuck you think. Any of you in the entire world. None of you. And you will never get this from me again. Well, Bruce, congratulations. I love you. Do you love me too?
I love you.
You would be stupid if you didn't.
She resuscitates me, she fucking hates me, and I love it, wait.
guilty about Ethan. I put a pair of things in a box. I cast one box. I have that much depression.
Thank you.
my pharaoh find some way to entertain his queen.
And what is it you're going to do?
Oh, no matter what's there.
Do that when they don't have a stable diet or things to boxes to neutralize them, such as I have right now. I think we need to help Ethiopia more. And there's definitely the KKK that are trying to tear them down and keep them where they are. I think it's important that they get to enjoy a bowl of soup or even lobster, just like I do. Go on.
Lobster and crab and...
Well, they can't in Ethiopia. Right now, we're doing a debate, ladies and gentlemen. That was cutting us out. Yeah. I think it's okay for anyone to enjoy the fine necessities of life. I've enjoyed the finest things in life. Lobster, salmon, caviar... But I'm happy and content with a spicy bowl of soup. Now, what would you say about that, Bruce?
A spicy bowl of soup is nice to have.
It is. I do like Tabasco sauce. But at the same time, there are people in Ethiopia and parts of Africa that actually dream of drinking spring water.
Any water?
Such as this. Any water, yes. Sometimes they have to boil their sewage just to have something to drink.
Yeah.
Now, what do you have to say about that?
Is that it? Hold on.
We're on pause right now. But let's wrap this up. Finally.
Advil presents Advil Minis. Fast ibuprofen pain relief. 23% smaller. Mighty small plus liquid speed. Advil Minis.